What is up, my fellow gamers? In today's video, we got our best beginner's guide and codes for the brand new global launch mobile game, Dragon Pal. I'm a few weeks late. We're like 2 weeks late because I was too busy exposing the scams on NBA Infinite. But I couldn't let this game pass us up because this is a pretty good one. Let's go over our coupon codes first. So we're gonna go into our avatar. We're gonna go to settings. We have our promo code section right here. First code is gonna be Dragon111. Go ahead, click confirm, get some free rewards. Now, the funny thing about this game is, honestly, when I started playing it, it instantly reminded me of Ninja Must Die. It's not the same developers, but it has that same vibe that Ninja Must Die had with that sort of action-packed RPG-ness going on. Next code is going to be Dragon777. Go ahead, confirm. And the last code is going to be DC for Discord Recruit. 111, go ahead, click confirm, and we get oddly a number of sixes for our gold amount. All right, next thing I want to go over is the invitation code. Now, everybody can go ahead and they can enter someone else's invitation code and you're going to get tons of free rewards, but you also have your own personal invitation code. So the more people that use your code, the more rewards you're going to get. So we're going to go over to where it says event right here in this top left. And then at the bottom, we're gonna scroll down to where it says call friends right here. This is where you go ahead and you find my night code. So this is the code that you want people to enter. I'll post my code down below in the comment section as a pinned comment if you wanna use my code. For this instance, I just copied a random code that someone posted in the Discord. And we're just gonna enter their code. So this is how you would enter my code or anyone else's code. Again, we're gonna go back to settings, that invitation code. All right, we went ahead, we entered someone's code, and we got a bunch of free rewards. All right, now I want to go over some beginner tips, strategies, some things that I have done to kind of help me progress the fastest. The first thing you want to do as a new player, you're just going to try and get through the campaign stages or story levels as fast as possible, because that's pretty much what's going to progress your account and unlock a lot of new features. There's a ton of features that you see on the screen you're not going to have as a new player. You're not going to have the ability to do rifts. You're not going to have like ancient rifts, or you're not going to have any of this as a new player. You just got to get through these first couple chapters of the story mission, and then a lot of things start to unlock. So prioritize the story first. However, once you get to the point where you do unlock this specific rift, which is gonna be right here at the top of this stupid little message, will go away, the timed trials. Once you unlock time trials, you need to prioritize this first. So stop doing the campaign levels and immediately start doing the time trials as far as you can get in them. And that is because it's gonna increase all of your AFK rewards. And it's really, really important. We're getting extra percentage for our gold, for our little meat stacks right here, the XP, also the crystals as well. So very, very important. Come in here, do this as soon as you have it unlocked. Once you get to a stage that you can't beat, then you're gonna stop doing the time trials. You're gonna go back to going ahead and progressing through the campaign levels. There's a bunch of events going on for new players. Specifically, the most important one is gonna be the beginner trial right here under the guide section. We have 8 days worth of different quests that you need to go ahead and complete. You wanna complete these because you're going to get the Warrior Priest Shield. This is an epic, so really, really good for free to play. As far as treasures go, these are a bit, I would say, controversial, because I feel like everyone has their own opinion when it comes to these. You have your basic stat, which has something to do with damage, and then your passive abilities are pretty unique and they kind of have different types of stacks. Any treasures that are going to increase your overall ability to earn more resources is always going to be your best bet for the long run. The way the treasures work, so you have two different ways to upgrade them. You have starring up and then you have refine. Refining them is going to just increase their passive effects. So if we refine this one, we're going to see that it's going to go from 4% to 4.3. You're gonna need some materials down below. We're gonna need some gold, and then we're also gonna need some of this rare mending liquid. The liquid that you need is gonna be based on the rarity. There are different types of liquids. There's like rare mending liquid. I believe there's an epic one that's purple. And as far as starring them up goes, you're just going to need basically a duplicate copy of the treasure, or equivalent would be a certain amount of puzzle pieces for that. So for this specific one, you're gonna see at the bottom, we need star stones. So we have 50, but we need 40. We're gonna need 40 fragments of that specific treasure. Tsaring it up is not only going to increase the passive effect, but also the basic effect as well. Another good example would be this one. I don't have it unlocked yet. This is the Pathless Tome. This is an excellent rarity. And for our passive ability, the XP of our training income is going to be +3%. We're also getting an increase to damage to elites. So this is an amazing treasure if you can go ahead and unlock this one. The way to unlock treasures is going to be in the bottom left corner in the gacha system. So you're going to be summoning for treasures. You can get a whole treasure or you can get the fragments for the treasure. After you get a certain amount of fragments, then you can go ahead and unlock the complete treasure. The other most important thing that I want to talk about before we wrap up this video, and that is going to be right here, your lift seals. Now this is going to be based on whatever chapter you are on, and this is super important. You're going to see this percentage right here where it says 73%. This is specific for our chapter 2 progression. Now when you're going ahead and you're doing these levels, if you take a look at the bottom, it's going to show you your recommended seal progress. So for this specific level, it's saying that I should have 50%. Currently, mine is at 73%. You always want to be as close to the recommended percentage as possible. If you're very, very well below the percentage, which I actually did one time, I was doing this level, stage 4, where it says 70%. My current, when I did this on the first try, I had, I think it was like 40% or something. So it was a big difference. I was like 30% behind in the recommended seal progress. And the enemies were absolute bullet sponges. And I didn't really realize what was going on. And I was like, why is this level so much harder than all of the others? That's gonna be because of your seal progress. If your current isn't close to the recommended, the enemies are gonna be complete bullet sponges and you're gonna basically do no damage to them. So in order to combat that, you pretty much gotta go and do the next highest stage possible that you can do. And you're gonna be doing like some farming. So you gotta replay these lower levels again and again. And every time you do that, you're gonna go ahead and you're gonna get these little items right here, these sealing stones. You're then gonna go ahead and use your sealing stones to unlock different talents on what I'm calling this talent tree, but this is the lift seals talent tree. And every time you go ahead and you progress through this, it's gonna increase your percentage. So right now I'm at 73%. The other thing you're also gonna come across is gonna be the keys. You're gonna have certain levels where it's gonna require you to have like 2 keys or 3 keys before you can progress. If you take a look at our stage rewards, we have our bonus right here, but this is the key. So we have 4 keys left. So all this means is we're gonna have to farm this level a couple more times to get all of the keys. So just be on the lookout for that. These different levels, they have keys that you do need to get in order to go ahead and progress to certain stages. That is it. I hope you guys and girls enjoyed the video. Stay happy, stay safe. I'll see y'all later. Peace.